Human beings spread all over the planet Earth, living in the most varied environments, forests, savannas, and even regions with low temperatures. And despite having a vastness of land at their disposal, the waters of the sea always incited an enormous fascination due to their countless mysteries. As time went by, people learned to navigate. With it came the will to explore the unknown and reach new places. Navigation also allowed a new form of commerce. More and more boats were built to carry the goods. Among the most valuable goods transported by sea were precious metals, high-quality wood, spices, and animal skins. By carrying highly precious cargoes, merchant vessels became the envy of other sailors, who began to organize themselves into groups to attack and plunder those ships. Those fearsome looters became known as pirates. The history of piracy began in the Bronze Age, but its registration and documentation turned into something more regular in ancient Greece. At that time, pirates were a threat in the Aegean Sea, attacking merchant ships from Egypt, Greece, and Turkey. As the ages progressed, pirates began to perfect their craft. Piracy turned into a very lucrative way of life. During the Viking era, the Western world experienced a new wave of terror. The Vikings were essentially pirates who not only attacked merchant ships, but also reached dry land to plunder towns and cities. With the arrival of gunpowder in the Western world, new weapons were created, capable of causing great damage with an ever-increasing range. Iron cannons were frightening weapons, capable of firing heavy metal balls from a long distance, or even several projectiles from a short distance. With the cannons, the pirates experienced their zenith, the golden age of piracy. By 1650, most European countries were fighting for control of maritime trade. Maritime trade was so important that there were several wars fueled by conflicts at sea. European powers were also looking for new lands to colonize in order to expand their territorial control. Often ships from Britain, Spain, and France fought each other, causing great destruction on the high seas. And in the midst of this chaotic, violent scenario were the pirates. The pirate ships navigated the main trade routes. Many passed through the Caribbean Sea, as this region linked North America, Central America, and part of South America. The Caribbean Sea is also full of islands. Many were commercial ports or places to replenish ship supplies, such as drinking water and food, for long trips on the high seas. For pirates, the Caribbean Sea offered the perfect conditions to organize ambushes and escape from the coral if necessary. Pirate incursions were constant in the region. They searched not only for valuable goods, but also captured the targeted ships. Most daring individuals attacked military ships, looking for ammunition or precious cannons. The islands most used as harbors by pirates were the islands of Jamaica, Madagascar, and the famous Tortuga Island. Pirates even built small towns on these islands, with trading ports, brothels, and of course, taverns to get drunk. Much of the money the pirates got from looting was spent in those places. The pirates sought to attack easy targets. They preferred to force the other ship to surrender without fighting. That way, they avoided wasting ammunition and ensured the goods were not damaged. In many cases, when the crew of a merchant ship surrendered without resistance, the crew was spared and treated with some respect. But if there was hand-to-hand combat, the pirates fought with absolute wrath, since they preferred death to be captured alive. The captured pirates were arrested and tortured. They were often hanged in broad daylight. To stop the threat of pirates, European governments hired ship captains and their crews as mercenaries to hunt pirate ships. The men in charge of hunting pirates were the corsairs. Some pirate captains even agreed to change sides in order to receive money for the persecution of their former fellows. Another frequent concern in a pirate's life was the likelihood of being seriously injured, given that doctors were rarely a presence on pirate crews. An injury to a leg or arm usually led to the amputation of this limb, and if the pirate survived, he would lose much of his value as a crew member. During the golden age of piracy, the pirate's favorite weapons were flintlock pistols and a short saber known as a cutlass. Both weapons were ideal for fighting in places with little room, like the deck of a ship. As identification, pirates used black flags on their ships, usually with skulls embroidered on the cloth. These flags were known as Jolly Roger. Many pirates used an eye patch, but contrary to popular belief, the aim was not to cover the loss of one eye. As pirates constantly walked between the darkness of the interior of the ship and the clarity of the deck, it was necessary to use the eye patch to keep one of the eyes rested. By doing this, they suffered less from the changes in brightness. Being a pirate did not mean having a life without rules or responsibilities. Every man aboard a pirate ship had to work hard to ensure his livelihood and to deserve to be part of the crew. Pirates followed a kind of code of conduct, which could vary between ships according to the captain's will. But some terms were followed by all pirates. Among them, the duty to obey the captain of the ship above all, the duty to share part of everything that was plundered, and never betray the other crew members. If a crew member stole a fellow's belongings, he was severely punished. And if he took the life of a fellow pirate without justification, he was sentenced to death. Pirates were famous for throwing people into the sea. This was done for fun, or to punish crew members who were rejected. Another even worse punishment was being abandoned on a deserted island with just a single bullet gun, forcing the unfortunate man to end his own life or die of hunger and thirst. Although not very common, some women were also fearsome pirates. In the West, the most famous pair were Anne Bonny and Mary Read, who were part of the same crew and won the respect and admiration of their fellow pirates. In the Eastern world, the most feared pirate was Ching Shi, Zheng Shi in Mandarin, who even commanded 40,000 pirates. She is considered the most successful pirate of all time. The captain of a pirate ship was entitled to keep most of the loot, but on the other hand, he had the enormous responsibility of establishing navigation routes and choosing the best targets. Some captains accumulated so much wealth that they began to bury their treasures in secret places. They usually looked for small, inhospitable islands to hide them. Captains also buried their treasures for fear of their own crew, in case they attacked out of envy or for any other reason. Many pirate captains left their names in history. Among them are the well-known Benjamin Hornigold, who became famous primarily for being a pirate. Then he switched sides and started hunting other pirates. Charles Vane, who, after suffering a mutiny from his own crew and being abandoned on a deserted island, managed to survive until he was captured by English sailors. Henry Morgan was one of the richest pirates of his time and was highly respected by other pirate captains. He became famous for attacking and looting the city of Portobello, Panama. And of course, the dreaded Blackbeard pirate, who terrorized the Caribbean Sea on his ship Queen Anne's Revenge. The golden age of piracy officially lasted until 1730. The decline of pirates occurred gradually. European powers fought fewer and fewer wars and increased the number of combat ships to patrol the trade routes. It was increasingly difficult for pirates to find targets without running the risk of being destroyed in a fight. The last pirates of the Caribbean ended their days fleeing the chase of bounty hunters or hiding in isolated places. There are no more black flags on ship masts, but for those who experienced chaos during this period, the word pirate remained synonymous with danger and fear.